the future of our country and what we plan to do now so that over the coming years, we write a story of American success and not decline. Because let's face it, if you think about where we're at in our politics these days, between all of the chaos and confusion, America's falling behind. I mean, we know this is true. We don't need some stat to tell us that. Today in America, our children are falling behind because our education system is stuck in the 1970s. Our workforce is falling behind because we continue to shield it from global competition with the heavy hand of government. And our government also falling behind because year after year, we saddle it with more and more debt, hamstringing our ability to address everything else. And the Constitution is also falling behind because so many shrug nowadays when those in power disrespect it. But worst of all, most concerning of all, is that many around the world are starting to wonder whether democracy itself is falling behind. Because you see, in America, truth is the thread that holds our experiment together. And that thread is starting to fray. Our enemies know this. It's why Russia and other countries are starting to attack the truth with disinformation campaigns meant to turn Americans against one another so that we don't focus on the substance of our problems. They know that the only way that they can beat democracy is to cloud the truth and make us question who we are and doubt the intentions of our neighbors. And that is exactly what they're doing. And unfortunately, the Republican Party, my party, isn't doing much to help these days. In fact, it often seems like they're making things worse, fueling the disinformation and division. Republicans in Congress will say one thing to get elected. They'll sing the praises of the Constitution, of limited government, of living within our means, but then do whatever they want once they're in power. The Republican Party just isn't principled. It couldn't even be bothered to draft a platform this year. It doesn't stand for anything except Donald Trump. Under its current leadership, the Republican Party is completely without solutions, and its future is bleak. That has to change. It must, because if it doesn't, the party deserves to be replaced. That's why we can't look to the party. We can't depend on it. We have to look to our principles. We need a new generation of leaders to stand up and start offering bold ideas that will push our country in a better direction. I believe those ideas ought to be rooted in opportunity. Opportunity is at the core of the American ideal, that anyone, no matter their race, creed, gender, or circumstance, can apply themselves to a pursuit and succeed. It's why we've long celebrated the pioneer, the self-starter, the entrepreneur, because they typify what it means to be an American. Because being an American isn't about looking a certain way or talking a certain way. It's about being a certain way. It's about a set of values, being self-reliant and driven, compassionate and enterprising, energetic and creative. It's who we are as a people. It's what makes us the greatest country in the world. Our politics and our policies ought to encourage that spirit. So what does that look like in practice? Well, I'd like to offer just a few ideas that could create opportunity in America. It starts by realizing that a quality education is the single best ticket for a child born to low-income parents to rise and achieve their dreams. We need to recognize that grade school is a better place to combat poverty than the welfare line. If you're a kid that grows up in America, you want to enjoy the same opportunity, whether you grow up in a poor rural neighborhood in the Midwest or the Upper East Side of Manhattan. That's going to mean improving our schools and strengthening families. It's going to require transforming our classrooms into laboratories of opportunity and not being afraid to boldly experiment until we discover the best way to educate kids. We can't rest until every kid in this country has the same opportunity to go to a top-rate school that gives them a fighting chance at success, no matter where they're from or how much money their parents make. And creating opportunity can't end in the classroom because it doesn't. If you work in America, you ought to be able to chase opportunity by learning new skills or changing jobs more easily. We live in the most innovative and disruptive time the world has ever known. And our workforce has to be just as adaptive because the economy isn't waiting for us to catch up. By 2030, one study finds that automation, and innovation will require up to a third of our workforce to either learn new skills or switch jobs entirely. What are we doing now as a country to prepare workers to seize that opportunity? We got to be honest about this, because if we continue to outpace the rest of the world and continue to be a global economic leader, it won't be because we coddled our workers and increased our tariffs by 30%. It'll be because we believed in our workers, that we invested in them and we trusted in their ability to out-innovate and outwork the rest of the world. And we need to realize that we can't seize opportunity as a country unless we all are able to seize it together. Because in a perfect world, opportunity would not discriminate on the basis of our skin color. But we do not yet live in that perfect world here in America. Black children graduate high school at lower rates than their white peers and are incarcerated at 5 times the rate. One study found that if your name is Jamal or Lakeisha, you have to submit up to 50% more resumes to get a job interview than you would if your name were Greg or Emily. And that's if the resume were otherwise completely identical. That is not making good on the American promise. If we're going to go out and capture opportunity, we have to be healthy. And that means having a healthcare system that works. It also means caring not just for the unborn, but also for the mothers and fathers who watch after those children after they're brought into the world. They have to be our concern as well. And we have to realize that none of this is possible. None of this is achievable if we neglect our national soul and character. This is so important. It's the foundation of everything. We need leaders with good moral character, people who put the interests of the country before their own. We also need people who respect the truth, the Constitution, and the rule of law, and who apply them even-handedly. Because if you're an American and you take the great risk of pursuing opportunity, and look, it's a great risk. It takes a lot to put your effort and energy into something. And if you do that, you have to trust that your government and your courts will give you a fair shake. So look, we can't sugarcoat it. Time is of the essence. But every day that we spend distracted by the latest tweet or the latest outrage is just another day that we fall further behind. That's not the America I know. And it's not one that we should accept. We are an exceptional country, a country that leads not by the force of its boast, but by the righteousness of its example. I'm ready for America to lead again. I hope you are too, and I think this convention is a hopeful start. Thank you for being a part of it, for raising your voice, and for defending the founding principles of liberty and equality that make America good. We can build the future we want together. We don't have to wait. So with a steady confidence, humility, and the blessings of a just God, let's get to work. Thank you.